Otherwise, Tomcat from Hellyeah. We thank you guys for sending in your questions. We'll do a little quick little Q&A while I'm down here at Dean Guitars and see what we got going on. The most important aspect of my playing is just the process of playing music itself. That's the enjoyment, the emotion that you get from playing, and especially for me, it's just a reaction of, you know, your fans and the crowd and just the live venue itself. But just in general, just playing and writing music is the most important part to me. Thanks, Marco. Jimmy Page, number one. Big time in Jimmy Page, Led Zeppelin. Huge Alex Lifeson fan from Rush. Really into his style. I listen to a lot of music outside of metal and rock. I like some techno sometimes. I listen to a lot of chill music. The Beatles, my favorite band ever. And technically, if you listen to some of those old Beatles songs, man, especially the really early stuff, even though it sounds very poppy, it's about as punk rock as you can get. So, but, yeah, listen to a lot of different stuff. A lot of blues. Just practice, and experiment, and listen to all kinds of music that could draw influence from, and then just stick to rock or metal. Just, you know, you don't want to pigeonhole your style. You want to get a variety of things that kind of shape you into what you become later. You know, once you acquire your own sense of style, you're gonna go back and look at those influences and really appreciate them a lot more. A lot of inspiration from Dime over the years. You know, when Pantera first hit, especially with Cowboys and Vulgar. I mean, to me, it just didn't get any better than that. You know? Even to this day, there hasn't been a band in hard rock or metal that has even answered that way. Right? Today, you just got a bunch of plagiarists, you know, and some people just kind of twisting things up so they can call it their own, but nothing is influential, and especially with him. I mean, people can look at his technique and be amazed by it, but the truth is, man, there's probably less than five people in the world that can do what he did so naturally, and so just utterly awesome. I mean, it's like almost to the point where you like feel yourself writing about it. But working with his brother Vince has been an absolute joy and treat. He's the most humble person I've ever met, most giving person I've ever met, and very inspiring, you know, and he's helped me become a better songwriter and kind of pull the reins back and harnessing his big monster power grooves in his hooks. That's really what it's all about. There's one right there. Look at that finish. Beautiful. Playing slide in a hard rock can be kind of tricky because it's hard to get, you know, slide is really a bluesy thing. And unless you're playing a kind of bluesy kind of riff, it doesn't really sound that great on top of some speed metal, you know what I mean? So what you want to do is experiment with a lot of open tunings, you know, like Zeppelin did, and that'll really kind of start you off in the right direction, you know, to the point where you can actually get back to a standard tuning and really be able to play, find your way all over the neck, figure out what works right. But it can be a little bit tricky. It's just a matter of just practice, and, you know, try some open tunings. Yes, we are going to do another record. Probably do another 50 records until people stop buying them. We're going to start this spring writing and try to have something out either by the end of the year or the beginning of next year. And next year we'll start touring hardcore everywhere, multiple times. What brought me is how enthusiastic and passionate the people that work for Dean are about the product. You can tell there's a lot of love put into the guitars, not just know, an assembly cookie line where just guitar after guitar after guitar after guitar and just stick out whatever you can. I mean, these guys really put their heart and soul into their instrument and their craft, and that's what really my favorite part about the guitar is. You know, you can feel when you play it how awesome it is. Everything's perfect, and it's quality work, and you know, that's what it's really all about. It's just the quality of it, you know, and how, plus it's just badass. I always prefer an unfinished neck. It happened because my first guitar, I still own it. It's a 69 Les Paul, and I've been playing it since I was 10 years old. And from just playing it, the finish has worn off completely on the back of the neck. And it's so fast, you know, a lacquered neck, when you're sweating, your hands are all just tacky, it gets really gooey and gummy, and, you know, it's just kind of sticks. And with an unfinished raw wood, you're just flying up and down. You know, you just treat it with a little oil and golden. Try it, you'll love it, you won't go back. It's been great. I'm down here visiting the Dean Factory, and I'm going to the DOA party tonight. I'm going to throw down with Vinnie Paul and Fry Dog, Cowboy, and Josh, and everybody from the company, and just getting away for a little R&R and going over some new designs for the guitar, which I'm not going to talk to you about because I'm going to see it. Lose your fucking mind over it. So, that's why I'm here. Going over some ideas. Well, you know, you gotta go out there. I call it going out and sucking. You know, you have to go in your van, pull in a trailer, and play and play and play everywhere you can in front of 5 people, 10 people, 100, or 1,000. You have to do it. You have to go through it so that you can get seasoned. It's almost like, you know, it's kind of like giving yourself a rebirth almost. You know, you know, a lot of people think it's a lot of glory, which can be, but you're going to have to accept the beginning of it, and that is a lot of work and a lot of dedication, and you have to have patience and the will to succeed, because if you don't, you know, it'll take you over and it'll just crush your spirit, and nobody wants that. You always want to succeed in what you do, and you just have to keep going and going and turning out. And like I said before, just be as original as possible and do something that in your heart you know that nobody else has done. And write music for you. Don't write it for radio or write it for record companies or write it because your friends think it's cool. You know, then you're just kind of setting yourself up and you're faking it. Just be as real and as honest as you can. Because once you do that, you got to live with yourself. And you'll be able to sleep at night knowing that you're being true to your art. Everything's a fool!